Hello viewers, I'm Ron Gran and you're watching 284 Media out of Tortola in the beautiful British Virgin Islands. A happy Tuesday to each and every one of you. I trust that you all had a beautiful day. There have been a number of issues that have been impacting the youth of the territory of the Virgin Islands. Recently, Leader of the Opposition and District 8 Representative, the Honorable Marlon A. Penn, sat down with a group of young people to discuss a number of issues that are affecting them at a youth forum. He's going to be touching on that as well as issues that have come out of that meeting in addition to a number of different situations that have been taking place within the territory of the Virgin Islands and more so District 8. All this and so much more after a word from our sponsors. You're watching 284 Media.
You value traditions.
Today.
You value music. You value education. Family.
I love you.
Service.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Love. Life. At Popular, we're committed to you and everything our community values. For the things you value the most, count on us. Popular.
Viewers, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Honorable Penn, thank you for your time this evening and welcome back to 284 Media.
Pleasant afternoon. Thank you as well, Ron, for the opportunity to speak to you once again and people of the Virgin Islands.
Now, as mentioned in the introduction, you recently held a youth forum in the East End area, of course, that was tackling a number of issues, presenting a forum for really the youth of the Virgin Islands, not only in District 8, but across the territory to come to speak to you and your colleagues regarding some of the issues that may be affecting them. Tell us about that youth forum, how it went, and what are some of the issues that were presented to you?
All right, thank you, Anna. I think, first of all, thank you for the opportunity again to speak to you and the people of the Virgin Islands through this medium. Yes, Ron, we had an interesting conversation with the young people, not just of the 7th and 8th district, but we extended it to the wider Virgin Islands, and quite a number of young persons came out, expressed their concerns about the way things are going and just what they would like to see moving forward in this country. And we gave them an opportunity to just speak freely, not in any pressured environment, a more relaxed, controlled environment where they could be comfortable to speak about the concerns that they have with their group, their age group, and within the territory as a whole. One of the main things that kept coming up, Ron, is the issue of unemployment and the issue of the difficulty for many of them to find employment in the territory, especially even before this COVID-19 pandemic that we've been struck with. Many of those young persons have a level of innovative ideas and solutions for us moving forward. Some of them are talking about getting into trading, getting into different ways of earning a living, starting a business, and the support that it would need to get those businesses off the ground are areas which they express concerns that they didn't have the level of support or didn't know where to go to get the support for themselves moving forward. So I think what came out of the discussion for me was that the young people are engaged. They're engaged on the issues of the territory. But they're not just engaged on the issues, they're engaged in solutions. They have a lot of solutions to bring forward. And I want to continue this forum to give them opportunity to just get those solutions on paper so that we can move forward to support them in some of these issues, specifically the issue of unemployment and where we could find opportunities to get persons more gainfully employed in the territory.
Now, with unemployment, as you mentioned, being one of the top concerns and priorities for a number of the persons, as a leader of the opposition, how do you suspect we tackle this issue moving forward?
One of the areas that I looked at, I think, coming into the COVID era, we know that this would have been a challenge because COVID would have been impacting particularly the tourism sector. One of the things that we suggested in May of last year to the government of the Virgin Islands is to do sort of a work for pay program where we look at addressing some of the infrastructural challenges that we're having as a country, but get our people involved in that process where you don't necessarily need the skilled labor to get those things going, but get persons gainfully employed, earn a living, and moving forward in terms of trying to find their way in the workforce, in the work field. Additionally, I think we need to look at ways where we could strengthen and improve our sectors that we have already. Particularly tourism. There are innovative ways that we could get tourism back up and running. I've been pushing that while we're going through COVID-19 and we agree that health is important.
Yes.
We've been at the stage where we have to get our economy going because you cannot have health without the economy. They all have to go intertwined. We have to be safe, but we also have to be responsible in getting persons back to work and getting them gainfully employed. And we have to find new areas to get persons ventured out. Many of our young persons have found innovative ways to earn a living. They've used technology. They've used different mediums to earn a living through the entertainment space and so forth in creative ways. And we have to find a way to tap into that creative energy. One of the things that I did and we pushed for as an administration when we were in power is the innovative lab in terms of the trade department. We created an innovative space where persons who have ideas could bounce those ideas off of each other and find ways to really support them in their business initiatives or any initiative that they might have moving forward. Those are things that we have to continue to push as we move forward in terms of finding new economic pillars and ways to really get the economy going again.
You spoke about the innovative lab that was created. How successful would you say that program was?
The unfortunate thing, Ron, is that we, when I was there, just before the last general election, I know the infrastructure was bought, the program was established, but it fell flat. As far as I'm aware, it's not active, it's not functioning. I know that the junior minister then had one function at Maria's, and I've not heard anything since in terms of that lab's moving forward. I think that is something that we need to continue to get going again. With all the different initiatives in terms of the Trade Commission, will help to create new opportunities and diversify our economy, find ways to diversify our economy. One of the other areas that we looked at was sort of a business incubator, where you have persons who might have business ideas, might have an idea to move a business forward, but they don't have the space to work. They don't have a location. They might need to have shared resources, shared space. And a business incubator will give us that opportunity where persons within similar spaces could work and bounce ideas off of each other and sort of strengthen each other's business ideas and business plans and businesses moving forward. Those are initiatives that were on the table. For whatever reason, they have not moved forward those initiatives. But I want to encourage the government that those are things that we need to look at to find ways to strengthen and diversify our economy moving forward.
Honorable Minister, I could be wrong, and you could correct me if I am. It sounds like we have a holistic consistency problem as it pertains to following through with various initiatives. Like you mentioned, both in your administration and now continuing on with this administration, ideas were brought to the table as it pertains to unemployment with the innovation of this lab. But it doesn't seem that much follow through has been the case. Why do you think that is?
I don't know, Ron, and one of the things that I continue to push is that government is a continuum, and that's why it's important for us to have a national development strategy for this territory. If there are ideas that are good ideas for the territory and the people of the territory, regardless of the administration in power, we need to push those ideas forward. And that's one of the things that I've always pushed and I always discussed, because the ideas of the business incubator, the innovative labs, these are good ideas for the territory. But we need to have a national strategy. I noticed that the government has moved forward a national strategy that was developed, that started on in the last administration, which is a good thing. But we need to set our national priorities. And development of our economy should always be paramount and a national priority. We have to find ways to ensure that all our people, especially our young people, are involved in the development and growth of our economy. And where there are innovative ideas, you need to have a system and infrastructure to make sure that we foster those ideas into whatever we do in terms of the economic diversification. But all in all, we need to have a national strategy, a national set of agenda items that are in the best interest of the country overall, and whichever administration is in place, we need to move those ideas forward for the best interest of the territory and our people.
You mentioned earlier about tourism and, of course, getting our economy back up and running.
Yes.
As you all know, we're getting ready to welcome our cruise ships back to the territory, and we trust that this will be a smooth process. It's been a long time coming, but as you look at that industry particularly, where would you say we are in regards to not only welcoming the ships back, but really holistically trying our best to revive the tourism sector?
I think we, as you said, we're a long time coming. I think it's something that we should have moved forward swiftly on. Unfortunately, this is where we are, but we have to move, because the reality is a lot of persons who operate in that space have lost a lot of their economic base because of being out of work for almost two years now, Ron. In addition to that, I think we need to look at our overall environment. We're welcoming tourist ships back to our shores, but yet still we're yet to get the physical environment in a place of welcoming. I have expressed this to the minister responsible, both ministers responsible, that we need to find a way to get our environment. See, some movement is happening in that space, but we're not moving quick enough to make sure that our physical environment is welcoming, not just for the cruise ship visitors, but for or everyday persons who live in the Virgin Islands, or residents, you know, visitors overnight as well, who come and patronize our environment. I'm getting good reports from the charter industry, from persons in the villa industry, persons from the overnight space that their bookings are there. Beautiful. I'm happy that the government has taken a decision to really, at some levels, forego the portal, so to make the transition of persons come to the territory more a smoother transition for persons to come to the territory. I think that is important because we need to welcome persons back safely, but we also have to make sure that the process is as seamless as possible. And the portal provided a level of frustrations for persons who come back to the territory. So we need to make sure that we're consistent, and we still need to pay attention to the health and safety protocols. And I just want to encourage persons, not just the visitors, but persons who live amongst us, our residents, to really be responsible and respect those safety protocols so that we can have a strong tourism season and really get ourselves back on some type of economic footing after the difficult 18 months that we've had so far.
You are the District 8 representative, but more so the leader of the opposition. And with that, I would love to ask you your thoughts on education. Of course, thankfully, our students have returned to face-to-face sessions for the most part. A few months ago, we did have an outbreak in one of our private schools. What do you say to the protocols, both in the public and private schools, in this COVID era? And where do you think we are as it pertains to keeping our students safe and continuing to have them inside at the classroom?
I think we just need to keep pushing, Ron. I think at the end of the day, we have to move forward from COVID-19. We have to continue to move forward in a safe way. And I've visited many of the schools since the reopening of schools. You know, you see where the teachers are taking the safety of their students very seriously. They're sanitized before they come into schools. They ensure that their masks are on. I see during the day, they're making sure that their masks are on and their communication is in a responsible way. So I see the teachers and within institutions are doing their very utmost best to keep our students safe. Because it's important for us to have that interaction, face-to-face learning. It's critical for the overall development of our students in the institutions. But I also want to, I was very disappointed in terms of the infrastructure. And we need to do a better job in maintenance of our physical infrastructure in our schools. And it goes back to us having a holistic approach in terms of upkeep and the maintenance, not just of our schools, but of our overall public infrastructure. As a territory, we've always done a very poor job of maintaining our public infrastructure, and it's something that we need to focus on and have a more comprehensive approach to maintaining and upkeep of our public infrastructure.
On the District 8 front, I must ask you, what's been happening and any new developments within your constituents?
It's been very slow, Ron. I must admit, and I've been very, me and there's been some, I won't say confrontation, back and forth between me and the ministers, because they're issues that need to be addressed in my community. And the reality is that those issues can only be addressed through the executive, who controls the budgets to deals with those issues. Issues of the roads, the issues of just the overall maintenance of the district. Many of the areas we have to take in, members and citizens and myself have taken matters into our own hands when we've had to maintain some of the areas within our communities. We're talking about reopening tourism, and the place is just very unsightly, Ron. Many of the guts have not been cleaned for over the last 2 years. We're going through, it's been raining a lot lately, normally in November. We get a lot of rain in October and November. We have to ensure that those public infrastructure, as I continue to say, are maintained and maintained properly. From my district point of view, I'm going to continue to call out on the premier and his ministers. We need to put the resources, which has already been budgeted for, to get those issues addressed. One of the beaches in my community, the Long Bay Beach and particularly Josiah's Bay Beach, are one of the beaches that are frequently, regularly, by tourists it comes to the Virgin Islands. Especially our cruise tourism now has used the Long Bay Beach as an alternative, or as not so much as an alternative anymore, as one of the options for persons who want to come to enjoy a good beach in the territory. They opt to come to the Long Bay Beach. And we have to get those environments up to spec of what we're presenting as a territory. It doesn't vote well if we don't have a presentable image when persons come to visit our shores. So I want to again reach out to the Premier, who's the Minister for Tourism, the Minister for Transportation, the Minister for Health, who is responsible for the derelicts. And I want to make a public plug, Ron. We've started an initiative in our community where the police officers in the Eastern Island community, we've worked with the tagging of all the derelicts within our community. And I've also reached out to some private persons to pull them away from our community, off the streets, off the side roads. And we're now initiating, I think it's tomorrow, is the first wave of those vehicles that we remove from our community. And I want to thank the sergeant within the Eastern community who worked closely with myself and the Ministry of Health personnel to get those vehicles tagged, and those private contractors who are supporting us to get those vehicles out of our community. So we are now on a community level doing the things necessary to get those things done, because the reality is that we have to get the cleanliness, the upkeep of our communities to a standard. And I want to again say to the ministers responsible for the budgets to do those maintenance, you need to get those things done. We need to get those things in place, the cleaning of the guts, the cutting of the bush, and all the things that we need to do to get us, our communities, not just in my community, but throughout the territory, back up to a place that we all should be proud of.
On an executive level, why do you think some of the issues or matters that need to be addressed within your district are not being attended to?
It's just like pulling teeth to get just the basic things, just to get the gut clean. I mean, I've been waiting now for months to get the guts in my district clean. I've said to the minister, I know the minister has been working under budget constraints, but I'm seeing works being done in other districts. So sometimes it makes you wonder on what is really happening. I hope that that's not the case. I don't want to speculate, but what I want to say again to the minister publicly is that we need to get the guts, the roads trimmed in our community. There are too many potholes throughout our community, especially a community where you're going to send a tremendous amount of traffic to the Long Bay Beach, coming with the cruise ships that are coming in, persons who are coming in through the Beef Island Airways, the Beef Island Airport, who have to traverse through my community. We have to do better than this. It's unsightly. I've taken as much as I could out of my personal resources. Persons in the community have said, look, we see what's happening. We have to support to get some of these things done. They've stepped up from the bridge area. You've seen work has been happening there. That's happening from a private contractor who has said, let's work together to get this done. So we're doing the things that we can do on our own, but government has a responsibility for the maintenance and upkeep of the environment. And the executive has a responsibility in that regard. We have a budget, and the monies need to be spent equitably across the territory, and our community needs to get the support to get those things done in our community.
Honorable Minister, I'd like to thank you for your time once again, and of course, voicing your concerns and also your take on a number of the issues that are facing our communities. As we close, I'd love to give you an opportunity to greet the people one more time, particularly the members of the 8th Electoral District.
Now, I just want again to thank the people for the district for their constant support within me and supporting and bringing their issues to the forefront. I will always be a conduit for your issues, your concerns, and be your voice in the House and in the public. I also want to say to the persons in the tourism space, particularly in the overall economy, we're anticipating an uptick in tourism numbers based on all indications that were given to me by persons within that industry. I want to say to those persons, just be safe, be responsible in terms of respecting the safety protocols. COVID is still around. We have to respect COVID-19. As well as persons living in the territory, just be responsible, not get too relaxed when it comes to ensuring that you respect the protocols, wear your mask, sanitize, and just be safe during this very difficult period.
Thank you once again, viewers. That is all the time we have, but of course that is not all the content. Stay locked to our page and of course our website for all of the latest happenings, both locally, regionally, and internationally. I'm Ron Grant. Do enjoy the rest of your evening. Bye-bye.